Hey there, everyone. This is Eizen the Broniac here. You actually caught me at a bit of an odd time here. You're going to notice two things, well, three things out of line here. First of all, I am doing this with a script, as you can no doubt tell. Like, right there, it's my script over there. The other thing is, this isn't usually the setting that I use, so I apologize for that. And if you're wondering why it's all shaky every now and then, there's actually a very good reason for that. It turns out that kickstand I use, I actually broke it. So, yeah. We're not going to be using that kickstand ever again. It's like I wanted to do just one fine adjustment and I would have been fine using the kickstand, but nope, apparently not. So, you know, as far as the environment goes, echo! Whatever. Anyway, getting to what I've been trying to talk about before going into this whole subject. In case you were wondering, my status here, I've actually been fine all of this week. You know, I don't feel sick anymore. Don't feel like
that is my sore throat still affecting me. My precious.
Like that, it's probably gonna hurt my throat now that I talk. I'm able to talk, which is nice because you don't want to hear. Wait, I already did that joke. Stop it, Eizen! You're just repeating yourself. I've actually been pretty fine throughout this week, but because of my sickness last week, it kind of put me in a bit of a procrastinating mood, so I apologize for not uploading any videos. Now, if you're someone who's still interested on me wanting to play through and beat all of Mega Man Paradise, and or your beau watching this, do not worry. I am still planning to beat this game by the end of the year. Having said that, I'm kind of thinking I want to do a different Let's Play for the time being, and I actually forgot to do it, but notice that I'm going to be saying Let's Play in quotes there, because even though I say it's a Let's Play, it's actually going to be more of a riff of the game rather than a Let's Play. Now, I'm sure you're all wondering, well, you're doing a riff. That already sounds interesting. What game is it going to be riffing? Well, although I can't say what the game is, I can at least tell you the game is somewhat horror-based. You know, we're in October, just in time for Halloween, right? Anyway, aside from that, how exactly have I been? I'm still working at Soaring Eagle Academy. Love working there, by the way. I mean, back when I worked at Target, it was like almost 7 years. This job here, not even a year in, almost feels like it trumps it all together. And I almost feel weird using the term trumps with the whole Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump, whatever. I don't want to be political. I shouldn't force you to be political. But anyway, you know, it just kind of sucks, you know, trying your damnedest, wanting to work, but instead kind of forced to stay at home. I mean, if it was just for my health, I would not mind working. Or if it was somewhat based on my coworkers' health, I guess that's important too. It's working around kids. You definitely don't want to get them sick. I mean, it's bad enough when adults get sick. Can you imagine what it's like when a child is sick and they still have to head off to school? They almost feel no motivation to study or have fun or even concentrating on their schoolwork while doing so because all they can think of is, it sucks being sick. And even if they don't say they're sick to your face, you can instantly tell on their face they are sick and don't want to attend. But and anyway, I am glad to finally be healthy and start working again for many various reasons. Because one, I can only stay at home for so long before I eventually get bored of stuff to do. And B, if I don't work, how else can I afford food or other stuff to take care of myself when I'm out of work if I can't earn money? So there's that. And but yeah, this video is just a heads up for you to let you know I'm not dead. I'm still active here on YouTube. Which is actually another subject that I want to bring up with you. I mean, as you can no doubt tell on my Daily Motion channel, I've been kind of neglecting it. No, seriously, the last video I uploaded there was my trailer video for my own Final Fantasy V 4. Fiesta run. And that was back in June, if not early May or late May, so it's been a while. And I do want to keep updating my channel, I mean, and keep it, because how else am I going to upload blind reactions of MLP episodes, MLP stuff, and other various videos like my Eyes and Try series, which is yet another thing I've procrastinated on to get back to uploading. But that's kind of another thing I'm concerned about. I mean, yes, I have my Daily Motion channel there to upload stuff that I know YouTube would panic the shit over when it comes to copyright claims and other stuff. But it's getting to the point I'm almost concerned no one's actually paying attention to that channel anymore. And of course, it's begging me to ask the question, is my Daily Motion channel even worth keeping anymore? I mean, I'm glad that I'm starting to get more views on YouTube nowadays. I think it went from 108-109 subscribers to 119, which I am ecstatic about. It's showing that people are at least getting some interest in what I do. Now, if they could comment on my videos, and by comment, I mean actually comment about the video and what I'm doing, not just, oh, this is a cool video, this is nice, hey, why don't you click on this link, why don't you subscribe to my channel, blah, 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 blah. Are you even concentrating on your own videos, or are you just self-promoting yourself? Those I cannot stand. I'm getting off topic. So, don't get me wrong, I still want to keep my Daily Motion channel regardless. But aside from my MLP blind reaction stuff and my Eyes and Tries, I actually want to ask you, is it really worth keeping my Daily Motion channel updated every now and then? See, I'm asking you about this matter of whether or not you want me to continue this or not. And please, leave a comment on this video about it. And like I said, not the self-proclaiming spam videos, an actual comment. Let me know how you feel about this, because even though it doesn't show it, your comments really do help me come to a decision. So please, let me know what you think. Now, of course, this kind of stuff I could have easily commented over with anything, really, because, you know, if that were the case, I would just put up another Cook, Serve, Repeat video for you. So, with that said, why am I even bothering with a camcorder-style recording of this? Well, it turns out that my good friend, Goku8170, is starting a Besom campaign. And, of course, Besom is a tabletop RPG, which, of course, the term Besom itself is an acronym for Big Eyes, Small Mouth. I mean, kind of picture Dungeons & Dragons tabletop RPG, only except of just Dungeons & Dragons, it's mainly manga and anime inspired, hence the Big Eyes, Small Mouth. And actually, it's not just me and him, but actually me, him, and a couple of his own friends are starting this as well. And of course, I know how this game works. I mean, you can just tell by the confidence of me having only played a few sessions of the game. When it was many years ago, back when I was still in college. So, yeah, you can feel the enthusiasm coming out of me. anyway, that alone doesn't sound like it's interesting, so why am I still bringing it up? Well, ordinarily, that doesn't seem important. However, the place we were holding our first session, which was really just for a character setup, we haven't really officially started playing. That's going to be for next Saturday and every other Saturday from there on out. We were having our session inside of Gamer's Paradise down in the Yorktown Mall. The reason I bring that up is that this place was also selling some MLP Beanie Babies. And I know what you're thinking. Eizen, you already have the main six. Why are you still collecting them? The main six, yes. But here's where it gets interesting. You see, the Beanie Babies that I got involved the princesses as well. Because, let's see, I have for you Princess Trollestia. We got that, and already I hate her smile because of that. You can already tell, I really didn't get a good look at these before I bought them. It's like, oh, all the three princesses are here. Buy it now! Because there were actually only one of each of them there, so I figured I'd get them. So, yes, we have Princess Trollestia. We have Princess Lawn Dart. And if you're watching this, Dave, Ogre, Nobleblood, whatever, insert name here, whatever, who's got bent wings and all. thank you for giving me that new title name for her. And again, it's pretty much a carbon copy of the same. It's just slightly different colors, and for obvious reasons, they're cutie marks, which it is so dark, I'm not even sure if it can show. Yeah, there's Lawn Dart and Trollestia. So yeah, there are those. The main reason that I got it, though, the true princess, Princess Luna. And look at that. You don't need a huge smile, just a small one there. And of course, it's too dark. You're not even going to tell. But this is how you make a princess Beanie Baby. Just love it. So epic. So yes, now I have all the main six ponies as Beanie Babies, and now all the princesses as Beanie Babies. And if we want to include Twilight Sparkle in that as well for both categories, yes, that's still all of them. Which, speaking of My Little Pony, I've actually been talking with some conversations with Bo, but mainly with Kyrex a bit. And I think I delayed my blind viewings of Season 6 for long enough. I mean, I don't even have the editing tools or programs to make my own videos, you know, the picture-by-picture bit. But I still want to give these blind reactions a go, now more so than ever, especially since, as of this recording, the fourth Equestria movie, which I think was, it was Everfree something, like camping, summer session. It had Everfree in the title, that's all I know. That movie is out, and I can't even continue reading the main MLP comic series anymore because, big shock, one of the characters there is Starlight Glimmer. And if it's going to dive more into her character, like how her character is in Season 6, I definitely do not want to continue any more so without getting a blind reaction of these videos. So at least I'm finally excited to get those out of the way. Again, I don't have the tools to edit those out, but trust me, one way or another, I will commentate on those with Kyrex, and I will find a way to get those uploaded ASAP, so trust me on that. But at any rate, I do believe I've rambled on more so for long enough. So this is just a video to let you know, no, I am not dead, but yes, I am still here and active on YouTube. But with that said, this has been Eizen the Broniac saying thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for the Mega Man Paradise game that will come out later this month, if not at the very least, November. I'm just going to say, even if not November, I am definitely going to get it done before the end of the year. Trust me, I want to get it done before the end of the year, because after delaying indefinitely Mega Man March Madness for this year, I greatly have to make up for next year. So you can no doubt tell what I'm going to be doing throughout if I don't get it done by November / December. All of January and February solely dedicated to that. So don't be surprised if during then I'm not going to upload any more videos during the time, because I'm going to be too busy doing stuff other than that. But there's that, and the mystery game that I'll be LPing / riffing in just in time enough for Halloween. But with that said, folks, take care, everyone, and I shall see you all later, everyone. And I just repeated myself in this echoey room. Why am I not stopping this video? Just end this video already. I want to go back to my old room and commentate with this, so you don't hear an echo from me unless it's purpose. Whatever. Goodbye, folks.